got a doll baby, I love her so. Nothing else like her anywhere you go. A man, she's anything but...
Hello everyone, and welcome back to my Fallout 4 Let's Play. So, we are outside Vault 114? I can't remember. And apparently Skinny Malone has his base in there. I'm guessing. I mean, his goons are guarding it, so... And they would have Nick Valentine in there, so... We are going to go get him back. This is an exposed place right here.
Damn it, I hate it when they open the door. Why is that thing so loud?
Vault 114. Is
that you, Skinny? Darla? What?
Okay. Darla. Yes, okay. So far, so good. If only Preston would keep his self under control. He really is not the best companion to have for a guy like Shane. Who wants to be all sneaky like.
Yes.
Duct tape is nice. Duct tape is always nice. Nobody else here. I, requires a key. Okay. Yes! More ammo. So, we're in another vault. Vault 114. Not very pleasant memories of vaults. Ooh, Vault 114 jumpsuits. Those are probably collectible. Okay, Preston, get off of me! Now, I'm gonna look at this terminal because I want to see what went on here. Obviously, no one lives here. Welcome, employees. Greetings! After many months of preliminary construction, we are pleased to welcome members of the technical and scientific staff to the newest addition to the Vault-Tec family, Vault 114. Like you, we are excited to get started on our latest endeavor, but we are not quite ready to open that great big gear door to our new residence yet. As you've probably noticed, we've contracted outside of Vault-Tec for construction on this one, since it is utilizing a unique space. By repurposing the former Park Street subway station, we will be seeing a decrease in building costs as well as a shorter timeline for construction. This fits perfectly with the vault's observational studies, which will be revealed in a future memorandum. However, because of this, we will be seeing a lot of civilian traffic until construction is fully completed. It is up to you to help maintain the security of Vault 114 and its experiment from prying eyes without proper clearance. Loose lips sink ships, of course. They also result in immediate termination and possible criminal investigations. Welcome, once again, Vault-Tec Management. So, of course, their little experiments... Warning, this memorandum is meant for members of the Vault 114 Science Division only, or those with appropriate security clearance levels. All others must exit this terminal immediately and report your infraction to the Overseer or a member of the Vault-Tec Security. As mentioned in your briefing, Vault 114 will be hosting high-ranking members of local and state government, local luminaries, business people, and their families. Further, future members are aware that they will be cohabiting solely with others of Boston's upper class. However, the luxury aspect of this vault has been highly exaggerated to the future residents. Multiple families, chosen randomly, will live and sleep in single-room apartments. Dining and bathing will be in shared quarters, and amenities will be minimal. In addition, we are currently interviewing for the overseer position for many candidates. Our goal is to find someone with no supervisory or government experience, and hopefully with a strong anti-authority bias. Human Resources tells us that the interview process is vetted mainly viable candidates. Many viable candidates. By taking away the luxury and authority these groups saw in surface life, we hope to study their reactions in stressful situations. As such, please do not undermine the new overseer's authority at all during the experiment, even and especially if it may cause physical discomfort, embarrassment, or harm to residents. Especially if it causes harm to residents? Okay. So, putting rich people in a situation where they're going to be unhappy. Well, I say they would have had it pretty much better than I did. My vault wasn't that great. Of course, it wouldn't have been that bad, actually, my vault, if we had actually all been able to wake up and continue our lives afterwards. Anyway. Whoops, wrong button. Wrong button again, what in the world? I suddenly forgot how to sneak. Ooh. Okay.
Say hello to goodbye!
Say hello to... Say hello to goodbye? Is that the name of your baseball bat? Water. Okay. That guy was in there that whole time. I didn't even see him or hear him.
Guess you've got your reasons, but that just looks like junk to me.
Shush! We're trying to sneak! This place echoes and you, like, practically shouted that. And it's not junk, I told you already. Aluminum cans are for modding my gun! How many times do I have to tell you?
So I got a question. Why the hell would anyone build a vault out of a subway station? This place is like the opposite of airtight.
Because they weren't planning to use it, you moron. We used to pull this kind of con all the time back before the war. Get a bunch of union boys to work some construction job that would go nowhere. Keep everyone on payroll.
Preston, I'm gonna smack you. Okay. Let's just quickly look around in here. I have a feeling I'm not going to be able to take everything out of here. I really do. No, I didn't want that. I actually really didn't want that. I don't have enough carrying capacity to carry extra 10mm pistols. I don't like this. This is an area where...
What the?
Come on, get him, get him! No! Oh, I totally missed.
Over here!
Shane actually looks pretty good with the leather jacket and the sunglasses. Nah, I'm not gonna be able to get him before he hides. I These guys are actually pretty tough. Woo! Nice! Except, I am getting shot. No, can't get them both. There's one left.
Sword control burst.
Are you talking to yourself? I don't have a weapon that does controlled bursts of anything. There we go. Is that all of them? I think we got them all. I think you might have got a couple of them, Preston, but really. More 50 calibers. Huh.
This vault must not have been quite done when the war started.
Uh-huh. We figured that. We gathered that from the terminal, remember? Somebody put ammo in their lunchbox and took it to work. It's kind of funny. There's a toolbox over there. I know there's radiation, but I wanted to just... I'm not gonna make it. There could be more around, actually. Did we shoot any that went down there? I don't think so. Okay. Nobody in here?
What are you gonna do with that?
I'm gonna use it to light up my house. Ah, nice. Oh, I don't need Coca-Cola bottles. Preston, stop walking in front of me like that. Oh. There's a hole. Now, you know, I bet there's people down there. No? There's actually no one down there? Okay. There's no one down there. Then let's go down there ourselves.
Oh.
There was a second level you could have dropped onto, you know.
Ah!
What? How'd you do that? Preston. Preston? Okay. That was really weird, you know. All right, there's another terminal. Let's see what else they have to say about this vault. This looks like the exact same thing I read earlier. Yes, it is. Okay, never mind then. So I improved my sneak, actually. So my sneak should be pretty good. Oh. Pretty good. If I didn't have Preston with me anyways, it would be pretty good. The only reason why I am not sending him away is because I need him to carry my stuff. He would actually... I wouldn't mind if he just went home. Are there people in here? I don't see anybody. Ooh, undamaged Abraxo cleaner. Nice and clean. Now see, if I was going to actually have a house to live in, I would collect stuff like that. I would collect stuff that hasn't been damaged. Clean things. Fill my house with clean things and try to make it feel more like home.
How you doing in there, Valentine?
Feeling hungry? Want a snack?
Keep talking, meathead. It'll give Skinny Malone more time to think about how he's gonna bump you off.
Don't give me that crap, Valentine. You know nothing, you got nothing.
Really?
All right.
I saw him writing your name down in that black book of his. Lousy, cheating card shark, I think were his exact words. Then he struck the name across 3 times.
3 strikes? In the black book? But I never... Oh, no. I gotta smooth this over. Fast.
Oh.
Wait. Something's out there.
Yes, you think. You really think so? Dino?
You okay?
I'm fine. That is fine. This vault's a lot bigger than the one I was in. It's actually made for people to live in. So that was Valentine up there. And I'm just checking some stuff. I'll be right with you. Be right with you. No, I didn't want the wrench. I don't want the wrench. What's that called? It's just like 3 different kinds of wrenches. Which one was that? It was just a regular old wrench. Okay. Can I unlock that? Yes, I can. Maybe.
Got it.
Ooh-wee. That's a pretty sight right there. I have a feeling that's the 3rd toolbox I opened that had Wonder Glue, toothpaste, or duct tape, toothpaste, and scissors in it. I probably can't carry those gas canisters. They're actually pretty heavy. Microscope.
Huh. After all these years.
What? Why do you keep saying that? Look, an undamaged metal bucket. Like I said, I kind of just want it for my future house. Preston?
Hey, just point me to it.
Carry stuff. He probably actually can't carry much. No, he can't. You know what? He can't actually carry anything else. Maybe he can't even carry a pack of cigarettes. Okay, I'll drop those gas canisters because they actually are pretty heavy. And I have a lot of other stuff like flip lighters and things that I can use instead. See? These weigh 3 pounds. I know I'm gonna find more stuff. Look at all. Look, I haven't even gone down there yet. It's just not fair. It's not fair at all. See? See? I can't leave duct tape behind. Overseer's door password.
Hey, you! I don't know who you are, but we got 3 minutes. Before they realize muscles for brains ain't coming back. Get this door open!
Okay. Take a number? Your number is 998. Okay. That's to That's to annoy all of the rich people that live here, right?
You gotta hack that terminal to open up this door.
I did it. See, I'm here. Hey.
My knight in shining armor. Question is, why does he come all this way? Risk life and limb. An old private eye.
What are you? You're a synth, aren't you?
Whoa. What are you?
Told you, I'm a detective. Oh, look, I know the skin and the metal parts ain't comforting, but it's not important right now. The only thing that matters is why you went to all this trouble to cut me loose.
Yes, well, I'm...
My son, Shaun, is missing. He was kidnapped. But I don't know who took him or where they went.
Missing kid, huh? Well, you came to the right man, if not the right place. I've been cooped up in here for weeks. Turns out the runaway daughter I came here to find wasn't kidnapped. She's Skinny Malone's new flame. And she's got a mean streak. Anyway, you got troubles, and I'm glad to help. But now ain't the time. Let's blow this joint. Then we'll talk.
Okay. Fair enough. Ooh. Can you wait? Can you wait a second? Because...
Perfect.
Oh, yeah. Oh, look at that. All vendors permanently have 100 more caps for bartering. Yeah.
There used to be small time. Muscled out of the old neighborhood by bigger players. So they found this place. Don't know what happened to the previous owners, but they're not exactly around to charge rent.
Oh.
Vault. Perfect hideout.
Okay, well, just can you wait a second? Nick? I want to see what there is here. There were a couple, aluminum stuff. I can't carry it. I think I have enough aluminum for now, actually. Okay, wait up. Was this door here before? I don't remember going... Because we came in through that one. I don't remember seeing this one here before. Well, there's another unused metal book. I only need one. I'm coming.
Hold up. I hear some of them coming. There they are. How do you want to play this?
His only job is to...
I
want to
play this sneaky like.
Why does that take so fucking long, huh? Hey, Dino, quit razzing that detective and get down here. Where the heck is he?
I'm pretty sure I can only get... I'll try to get all three of them. No, I can only get two of them. Oh, I actually can't get even two of them, I guess. Why?
Knucklehead.
They like that word, knucklehead.
Stay away, huh?
What? I didn't get him?
I think I got something over here. Found
Preston. Seriously.
Didn't even break a sweat. Not that it's an option.
Ha ha. Hold on. I want to loot these guys before we rush off again. Please. Okay. And pick up any wonder glue that I find as well, so... I mean... Even though I can't, you know, carry any much else, I want to make sure I'm not missing anything really important. Since we're blowing this joint, that means we're not coming back. In here. There's another vault. Do I need another one? Probably not. See? Look! I found ammo that I wouldn't have found otherwise.
Hard and loud, huh? Well, it gets the job done. Cleans up the floors.
Wait, Nick. Just wait a second. Rah! This is a tight little locker room here. You're going that way? Okay. Oh, this is a shower. Duct tape. See? I can't leave behind duct tape. I just can't. Or that. Another shower. Oh no, this is a bathroom. Lots of undamaged Abraxo cleaners in here.
This door's on the fritz. Let me see if I can get it open.
Okay.
Almost got... There we are. Hell of a lot easier to do when the lock isn't on the other side.
Huh.
I guess you've got your reasons. But oh. That just looks like junk to me.
Preston, I didn't even want to hear
that.
Oh, uh-oh. Oh!
Can't have gone far.
What?
Okay, our cover's blown. Not that we had any in the first place, actually.
Have a visual on them.
Not yet. There they are.
Anyone you walk away from.
Hold on. Ooh.
Excellent.
Gain 5 action points. Plus 5 action points. Nice. Nice, nice. Double nice. Wait, Nick. Wait. There's a locked door here. That means there's stuff behind it that I can't carry. Oh, it's a laundry room.
This one's all mine.
Okay, go ahead. I can't loot these dryers. Oh.
Shit. For you to take the ball.
I've got this one.
Good. Go along.
Alright, hold on. I'm looting this room too. They have pillows!
Enjoy your coffin!
They're up above me. Okay. Yeah, they have, pillows. Now, if I was going to have a house anywhere, I would definitely want a nice, comfy pillow. On my bed. Nick?
Still got some fight left in ya?
Noodle cub. Nick, where'd you go? I'm carrying too much. I can't go through there. Fine. Let's see what we can leave. Okay. I can't actually get rid of anything else. I just can't pick up anything else. Oh man! This isn't fair! It's not fair! Where did Nick go? Nick! Don't rush off ahead like that.
All right. Come out.
Another comfy pillow. I
one off the list.
I'm pretty sure
Ran
I don't.
Off.
Let's get it all back to the game, shall we?
Nick?
Travis,
where'd you go?
Bringing you Warren Smith with the uranium rock.
Oh. Clean plates and cans and clean thing. Clean dishes. See? I'd want to eat off a clean dish. I'm gonna take one.
Go ahead.
No, I don't want to talk to you. I wanted to loot these whiskeys. No, I can't loot the whiskey. Okay, you know what? Probably the reason why I can't carry anything else is because I have too much whiskey and stuff. That's the problem. Look, I have 8 melons. That's 8 pounds. I'm gonna drop these melons. Mute fruits don't weigh as much. I have 4 whiskeys. Okay, I'll just leave the whiskey, fine. I can't help it. Oh, there he is. I'll have to remember this
more
place.
Stairs? Who built this damn vault? A fitness instructor?
You're a synth, right? Do you actually care about working out and stuff?
There you are. Sharp.
Oh, I missed. Hello. I'm stuck. A nursery. Look out. Okay, hold on. I'm just checking. Oh, toy cars. I can't pick these up. I cannot pick them up. But I am gonna just check for ammo. Because I actually really do need more ammo. The very next thing we do after this is go buy ammo. We have a lot of, we actually have a lot of money.
You
no,
sure that's worth taking with us?
That's not what I meant to pick up. We actually have a lot of money now. Well, not a lot of money, but we have more money. We have money to spend on ammo.
Skinny Malone and the rest of his boys are waiting for us somewhere. The name's, ironic, but don't let that fool you. He's dangerous. Another locked door.
Okay.
Shouldn't be too hard.
Well, you're kind of handy to have around, Nick.
Okay, I got it.
I have...
But I hear big fat footsteps on the other side.
Okay.
Once I step through this door, get ready for anything.
All right. Does that mean I should quick save? Probably. All right, let's go. After you. Back out to Park Street Station. So we came out a different way.
Nicky, what are you doing? You come into my house, shoot up my guys? You have any idea how much this is gonna set me back?
This is
I
not
wouldn't
a good...
be here if it weren't for your two-timing dame, Skinny. You ought to tell her to write home more often.
Poor little Valentine. Ashamed you got beat up by a girl. I'll just run back home to Daddy.
She sounds like somebody I know.
Alone, Nicky.
This ain't the old neighborhood. In this vault, I'm king of the castle. You hear me? And I ain't letting some private dick shut us down now that I finally got a good thing going.
I told you we should have just killed him! But then you had to get all sentimental. All that stupid crap about the old times.
Dalla, I'm handling this.
She sounds like Marcy.
Always got things under
Marcy
control.
Long.
Oh, yeah? Then what's this guy doing here, huh? Valentine must have brought him here to rub us all out.
I'm not going to be able to convince her to leave.
Darla, listen to me. You have a home to go back to. You don't want to throw your life away with these thugs.
Don't you try to confuse me!
I knew it.
Get him, Skinny!
Preston liked it. Oh, no. This isn't going to be good. Come at me with a baseball bat. Ah, run! Get that one. Don't get in my way, Preston.
You should give yourself credit sometimes. You really are one of the good guys.
Well, so much for Skinny Malone.
Thanks.
Lighter or heavier with all those holes in it. And the bullets probably add a few ounces. Good night, sweet prince. Here's to all the old days. It'll be an awkward conversation with Darla's parents when I tell them their daughter bit the big one. Well, at least the case is closed. Let's get out of here. There's a service ladder that should take us right to the surface.
Okay, wait. I need to, he doesn't even have any good loot on him. He had a 10mm pistol, that's it? Oh, here's Skinny Malone. He had a tuxedo. Nick, are you gonna wait for me? I wanted to check in these guys mostly just have... Did I come... Oh, this is, I've been in here, right? This is the entrance. Okay, well, let me just loot the guys we killed, and then we'll be on our way. That's good enough. Okay. Alright, let's go. Nick, wait up. Where'd you go? I have a feeling that I'm gonna eventually not be able to pick up Wonder Glue even. I don't think I came up here. Did he go this way then? Service tunnel. There we go.
That Commonwealth sky. Never thought anything so naturally ominous could end up looking so inviting. Thanks for getting me out. How did you know where to find me anyway? Not many people knew where I went.
Ellie? Your secretary?
Your secretary, Ellie. She sent me.
She did? I should give her a raise. Now, you mentioned something about your son, Shaun. How he went missing.
Mm-hmm.
I want you to come to my office in Diamond City. Give me all the details. Besides, I think you've earned a chance to sit down and clear your head.
Yes. Diamond City. Yeah. I'll follow you there. I think I need to go back and sell some
Lead
stuff.
The way, Nick.
All right, let's move fast. Follow me.
Okay. Oh, I leveled. Can I just go to Valentine Detective Agency? Can I just level up real quick before I forget? Because I always forget. All right, what do I have here? What can I get? I need level 18 for that. Scrounger. Might be a good one. Oh, I can improve my sneak even more. Cool. And what else? I need level 5 for that. Mr. Sandman. Ooh. As an agent of death itself, you can instantly kill a sleeping person. Your silenced weapons do an additional 15% sneak attack damage. If I only had a silenced weapon. That's really tempting. Sneak 3. I think I'm gonna do this. Sneak 3 sounds like a good idea. And then I can get rid of Preston and it'll even be a better idea.
Traveling in the Commonwealth as long as I have, you learn a few things. These old buildings and alleyways give you a lot of opportunities to hide if things get bad, but that goes both ways. Always keep your eyes out and your head on a swivel. Things can go from calm to deadly in a heartbeat. Diamond City is as close to safe as you can get in these parts. Security keeps the perimeter under control, but it's always a struggle. Despite the mayor's bragging, it really is the most secure settlement around, even if it comes with a few uptight guards.
Huh. Yeah, I know. I kind of did notice all that. He likes to talk. But yeah, I like Nick. He's kind of a nice guy, I think. Oh, is this a shortcut? Because I did not come this way. Oh, look, it's right there. Well, he knows his way around. And I came from down there, though, by the river, so. Wonder if Nick would be interested in helping me. I don't think I ever went in there.
Hey, I thought I saw something.
Guess we're not alone.
Oh no. No, no, no.
Made us again.
There was just one of those standing here. Where are the guards?
We should get going.
We are going. Why are you so impatient all the time? Oh, that's right. All the guards that were here died. Red X. I'm coming. I like looting on the way. But I don't need my gun anymore.
Here the different raider groups are carving up Concord like a crispest turkey.
They did, but I took care of them.
Darling, are you sure about this? I am not a normal girl.
My dear, you're perfect. I only wish I had realized that sooner.
Then by the power invested in me, I pronounce you man and wife.
All these years, I never realized how much she meant to me until she said something.
You just married a Miss Nanny Bot. That was the one I talked to about love.
Who
needs a haircut. She was in love with the teacher. Okay.
You helped me make a very big decision. Thank you. I think I know what this love is now.
Okay. You're welcome, I guess. To each his own.
Walk outside the wall undefended. High quality protection for sale.
Okay.
Ellie? Are you here?
Nick? Oh, God. It's really you.
Well, it's hard to mistake this mug for anyone else.
You keep laughing at death. Someday, death's gonna laugh back.
Not as long as I got a few friends to back me up.
You saved Nick, this agency, and my job. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Hey, happy to do it.
Yeah? Go diving into scary pre-war ruins all the time then, do you? I know an amount wasn't on the table when you went out to find him, but you deserve a reward. Plus a little something extra. You know, if you're looking for work and don't mind putting on the detective hat, Nick sure could use a new partner.
Whoa. One case at a time, Ellie. Our new friend needs our help first. All right, let's get down to business. Take a seat. Make yourself comfortable.
Can I take off my sunglasses?
You're trying to find someone who's gone missing. The devil is in the details. Tell me everything you can, no matter how painful it might be.
Oh, really? Okay. Well,
we were in a vault when it happened. Vault 111. It was some kind of cryo facility.
You were on ice, huh? More importantly, you were underground. Sealed up. It's a lot of obstacles to get through just to take one person. What else can you tell me?
Describe the murder. Describe Shaun.
We're looking for my son, Shaun. He's less than a year old. Why would anyone take him?
Good question. Why your family in particular? And why an infant? Someone would be taking on all of his care, and a baby needs a lot of it. Anything else you remember?
My wife was murdered. She was trying to keep them from taking Shaun, and they just...
It's okay. You don't need to say anything more.
So, we're talking about a group of cold-hearted killers. But they waited until something went wrong to resort to violence. Well, that confirms it. This isn't a random kidnapping. Whoever took your kid had an agenda. There's a lot of groups in the Commonwealth that take people. Raiders, super mutants, the Gunners. And, of course, there's the Institute.
The Institute?
So you think this Institute is responsible?
Well, they're the boogeymen of the Commonwealth. Something goes wrong, everyone blames them. Easy to see why. Those early model synths of theirs strip whole towns for parts, killing everything in their way. Then you got the newer models, good as human, that infiltrate cities and pull strings from the shadows. Worst of all, no one knows why they do it, what their plan is, or where they are. Not even me. And I'm a synth myself. A discarded prototype, anyway.
You're a prototype?
You're a prototype?
As far as I know. Never seen any other synth like myself. There's the older ones that are dumb as rocks and all metal. And there's the newer ones that are almost human. I'm somewhere in between.
Okay.
Either way, I need to find Shaun.
You're right. The speculation is getting us off track. Let's focus on what you saw. What did these kidnappers look like?
Well, he had a distinctive what he did.
I'll never forget that voice. Low and rough. Like sandpaper across your face.
Not much to go on. But a tough and commanding voice can get someone pretty far in the violence business. What else?
He carried a gun.
The man who...
I remember that.
Killed my wife. He had a handgun. I didn't get a clear look at it. But that sound...
could have been a large caliber revolver. Huh. I'm starting to get a clearer picture of the kind of man our perp is. Anything more you can tell me?
The woman was dressed in, I think it was a kind of hazard suit. The man had some sort of metal brace on his arm.
Maybe some kind of improvised armor?
He did,
huh? A lot of hired guns do that to look
tough. I guess I'll take my word for it.
Hazard suit is interesting. Not many mercs can afford something that fancy. What else do you remember about them?
One of them came right up to me. Bald head. Scar across his left eye.
Wait. It couldn't be. You didn't hear the name Kellogg at all, did you?
No.
No. They never said their names.
It's way too big of a coincidence. Ellie, what notes do we have about the Kellogg case?
The description matches. Bald head, scar, reputation for dangerous mercenary work, but no one knows who his employer is.
And he bought a house here in town, right?
What?
And he had a kid with him, didn't he?
Yeah, that's right. The house in the abandoned West Stands. The boy with him was around 10 years old.
He's in town?
You said he lives here? He's still in town?
They both vanished a while back, if I'm remembering right. But that house is still there. Let's you and I take a walk over to Kellogg's last known address.
Whoa.
See if we can snoop out where he went.
Security doesn't really go to that part of town, but you two should still be careful.
I always am.
Follow Nick. Whoops. Sorry, I knocked your fan over, but...
I didn't want Ellie to hear this, but I think you should know. Everything I dug up about Kellogg before his disappearance is bad news. He's more than just a mercenary.
Good
He's
work.
A professional.
Most
quick,
sense scare the hell
clean,
out of him, Mickey.
Thorough.
He ain't like those instances.
Has no enemies, because they're all dead. Except you. But 9-to-1 odds says he's our man. It's more than just you identifying his distinguishing features. The M.O. is all him as well. Leading a small team to kidnap a baby and leaving one of the parents alive for later? Not many mercs in the Commonwealth can pull that off.
Okay. So is that his house then? Master Lock.
Here we are. Keep an eye out, will you? See if I can get this open.
Oh, yeah, okay. You can open it. That'd be great, because I know I can't.
That's one heck of a lock. Something to hide, Kellogg? Why don't you give it a try?
Oh, I'm pretty sure I can't.
Won't be able to pick this.
You know.
Hey, no Valentine.
Luck? Oh.
Guess we'll need to find the key. Stubborn lock, ain't it?
Yeah.
See that platform in the distance? Near the city entrance? That's the elevator to the mayor's office.
Oh.
Why don't you go ask around there? I'll stay here and see if I can jimmy this lock.
All right. Hopefully they just give it to me because... how much you want to bet? They're not just going to give it to me.
The latest hairstyles from the upper stands.
Read the public and be prepared.
Woo! Okay. You gonna come up here too? Wrong way. Alright, I'll be right back. Look at the view. Really rusty city there. Piper?
Why doesn't the mayor come out of his office, huh? He's afraid of talking to the press? A
bet if I said I was with the Institute, he'd come running.
Do you ever think maybe you could get a man's attention easier if you use softer words, honey? Maybe shout a little less?
Oh, that reminds me of this article I'm writing about the mayor's affair with a certain airheaded blonde.
Ooh.
Oh, look who it is.
Hi.
What brings you to the mayor's office, huh?
You first.
What are you doing here, Piper?
Nuh-uh. Not until it's in print. You can read all about it in the next issue.
Okay. Fine.
If
fair enough.
If you're crowding the reception area, Miss Piper, the mayor needs to make time for more responsible citizens.
I was just leaving anyway.
Bye.
Nothing stays hidden forever. At least, not if I have my say.
Hi.
The mayor's receiving visitors, as long as they aren't members of the press. Did you need help?
Yes. I need house keys. Or Kellogg's house.
I need to talk to someone about Kellogg's old house in the West Stands.
Mr. Kellogg's residence? He left town a while ago. We foreclosed on the property and locked it up. If there was something belonging to the man that you have a claim on, you could ask the mayor to hear you out. No guarantees.
Okay. Thanks. Well, can you help me, actually?
Come on. Can't you help me yourself?
And if I could, why should I?
Oh, man. Because I'm trying to find my son.
Please. All I want to do is find my son. The man who owned that house kidnapped him.
I've heard the sob stories before, so save them.
Oh, come on. Well,
never mind. Thanks for nothing.
Have a nice day.
I guess I'll see if I can talk to the mayor.
No funny business around the mayor. Got it?
Though, I imagine he's probably not going to be any more helpful.
Ah, yes. I remember you. Our new arrival. Uh-huh. I wish I was in your shoes. Getting to see our glorious city for the first time. How can I help you?
Kellogg's house. Nick sent me.
Nick Valentine wanted me to see you.
Did he now? Some investigation, I assume?
Yes.
You two aren't trying to get me into hot water now, are you?
Kellogg's house.
A man named Kellogg used to live in this city. I need to search his house.
I see. Well, whatever reasons you have, I take my citizens' privacy very seriously. Even after they've left. I can't allow you to invade someone else's home. That's all there is to it.
What? He's a kidnapper.
Please, Mayor McDonough. This man Kellogg kidnapped my son. I need to find him.
I see.
Oh.
I'm sorry, but however Preston horrible the crimes this Mr. Kellogg may have committed, your word alone isn't hard evidence.
So that's it?
So that's it? You're not going to help?
Security is part of what keeps Diamond City above the petty squabbles and misfortunes of the Commonwealth. I can't betray that for anything.
Bribe? I don't want to bribe him. Thanks for nothing.
Fine. Thanks for nothing.
I know it's disappointing, but I have to think of all the people of Diamond City, not just the needs of one person.
I really don't like you.
You really are one of the good guys, you know?
I don't want to talk right now, Preston. Can you tell? I'm busy.
I'm sorry, but you're not getting that key from me. Why do you want it so badly anyway?
I told you why. Maybe I can bribe her.
Maybe we can reach an agreement? I just happen to have a pile of caps here.
A gift? For me?
Yes.
Oh, how generous. Oh, there I go again, leaving a key out on my desk and forgetting to put it back.
Oh. Look at that. I'll help you with that. Ha! Got it! Finally, we can go. Find out what happened to Kellogg. And I just lost 250 caps, too. Maybe he has some in his house. that I can repay myself with.
Got a doll, baby, I love her so. Nothing else like her anywhere you go. A man, she's